Hey guys, my name is Ryan.
And my name is Mizka.
And welcome to Overwatch Central and welcome to Denied, a series dedicated to talking about how to bring down some troublesome heroes. We checked your comments and saw that the Ice Queen Mei was a problem you were facing a lot of the time. We'd like to think since the last episode you've gotten more experience in shutting down specific heroes, but if Mei is still giving you trouble, we've got you covered.
First of all, we need to decide what makes Mei a hero people are struggling against. She's definitely one of the most annoying heroes in the game and can disrupt multiple enemies at once. Her slow is applied as soon as the freezing beam hits you, so Mei can be effective when near an objective that the enemy is forced towards. When frozen by a Mei, there's not really anything you yourself can do. An icicle headshot or two deals a lot of damage, so you're relying on your team to save you or at least get a kill back on the Mei. Let's see how she fares against all the heroes and we'll discuss the results at the end of the video.
Let's begin with the offense heroes, starting with Genji. Any mobile hero will generally want to stay away from Mei as a slow means you are easier to hit. Genji does have a good chance against Mei in a 1v1 though, just don't hit the deflect button as it does nothing with the freeze. McCree and Mei play similarly to each other, but McCree's damage output is far better than Mei's, which means that he will kill her a lot faster. Keeping Mei at a distance is the best way to adapt your playstyle to beat her, and Pharah will naturally do this. Generally, Pharah is a reliable counter. Reaper can Wraithbomb out of the freeze, resetting the frozen time and giving him an advantage in a 1v1 scenario. Also a reliable counter. Soldier 76 is a bit of a 50-50 as you can't kill Mei that quickly. If you get a few headshots in, you'll win the 1v1, but Mei will have enough time to get you frozen still. And Mei is actually not a great counter against Tracer, despite being able to slow heroes. Tracer will simply zoop around and through Mei fast enough to keep the freeze timer reset most of the time, making it a fairly easy 1v1. But just like in Genji's case, you'll be easier to hit while slightly slowed, so watch out if Mei has backup.
Now to the defense, Bastion is first up. Mei will be able to wall Bastion off, thus helping herself and her team get through choke points. However, Mei will struggle to actually kill Bastion. Hanzo will struggle in a medium to close range 1v1 scenario, but has the edge when at a distance. If Mei cryo freezes, Hanzo will have time to line up a scatter arrow or headshot. Junkrat is a bit of a mess versus Mei, really. Either one of them can actually win in a 1v1 scenario. Since Junkrat's grenades deal 120 damage, you'll need to hit Mei with 3 of them, so keep that in mind. Mei versus Mei just comes down to who gets the other person frozen first. That's it, really. Torbjörn is in a very similar spot to Bastion, where Mei can avoid but not really kill him nor the turret. And finally, Widowmaker. Similarly to Hanzo, she can line up a headshot when Mei is in cryo freeze. If Widow keeps her distance, Mei doesn't really stand a chance at all. Generally, we find her to be a reliable counter.
Tanks overall tend to be a bit 50-50 with Mei. D.Va is susceptible to being frozen and icicled, but her health just means that she can survive through it and burn down a Mei with ease. Not a counter as such, but still fares well against a Mei. Reinhardt's shield does block the freeze. You've just got to make sure that the Mei doesn't get in behind you. And if she does, try to give her the old boop. Roadhog is similar to D.Va in that he can just take the freeze, right click, and has enough damage to take Mei out. But the outcome tends to vary on who wins. The same can be said for Winston. Man, apes aren't really having a good week this week, are they? And finally, Zarya can eat up the freeze with her shield and gets a good amount of charge from it as well, but once it's been used, you don't have much to protect yourself with.
Supports generally will not stand a chance with Mei, apart from Lucio. Lucio is quick enough to dance around the Mei, as well as his self-heal keeping him topped up with health. Not only that, but his alternate fire with the knockback enables him to make some space for himself and make sure that Mei can't get close. Mercy, obviously a hard counter again.
Why do we even bother with this one, Crest?
Symmetra relies on being close to do reliable damage with her left click. In a 1v1 fight, close quarters, Mei should win. Senyata's Discord Orb is nullified by the Cryo Freeze, and with your low health and low mobility, if Mei gets close, you'll be an Omnic Fridge in no time.
Of course, we do understand that these one-on-ones aren't as common in games, and each scenario has a lot of different variables. But as you can see, she doesn't really have as many direct counters as Bastion had in the last video. But really, countering Mei is more to do with the playstyle change. First and foremost, you need to keep your distance. Mei is strong because of her freeze, right? Her cryo freeze and walls are a pain in the ass, but they're not the things that are causing you to get annoyed. It's the fact you get frozen and your inability to prevent it. Mei can also set up a lot of kills in a similar fashion to McCree. So you want to play heroes that can stay at a distance and can still be effective. And also to protect your frontline from being disrupted by her. In a similar vein, try to always keep track of where the enemy Mei is. Defensive heroes all share this form of trait, that they're strongest when their whereabouts are unknown. Mei, Widowmaker, and especially Bastion all work in this way, So always be aware of what flank mate is hiding on so she doesn't get the jump on you. If she does start freezing you and you don't have a teammate backing you up, you're going to be frozen and the kill is set up. And no doubt you'll be icicled in the phase within a second. And lastly, teamwork makes the dream work. Solo kills one-on-one with mate is her Achilles heel. It just takes her so long to actually get these kills. I hope we've kind of highlighted this with the section going over all of the heroes, but generally, as we've already stated, the real scenario will be a bit different. Mei has a huge amount of sustain and ability to stall. She can dance around the objective front walls and cryo freeze to give her own team enough time to get back on the spawn. So group up and try and take her down as quick as possible.
Mei isn't that strong on her own either. She's more of a hindrance than a problem actually. Her ultimate is very delayed and has a loud audio cue, allowing you to get out of the way most of the time. Even if she throws it on top of a crowded objective, it just means you can't get on it for a few seconds. But when Mei's on top of the objective, she obviously has to be dealt with. But if she's off the capture area or payload, you can prioritize other targets as she won't just quickly burst you down out of nowhere. Last time we denied Bastion, another infamously annoying hero. But if you compare the two, you'll realize that Bastion can win a game on his own sometimes, but Mei just doesn't really do that.
But she is incredibly strong with help. Teaming her up with Azaria will allow her to stay alive for longer, which means her taking a while to kill heroes isn't as much of an issue. A Lucio can also speed boost her to minimize the time it takes for the Mei to get up in the face of the enemy. Generally, she can be made stronger by synergizing with her allies. So try and cut the link and alienate Mei from her team. Then it should be fairly easy pickings.
So to summarize, keep your distance as Mei need to close the distance to her enemies before she can be effective. Protect your front line as they will be exposed to her and make sure to keep track of where she is so you don't come around a corner and get surprise frozen. We recommend Pharah, Reaper and Widowmaker to deal with Mei and then for your other heroes to adapt their playstyle to deal with her rather than switching out those heroes as well.
And that's the end of this video, thank you very much for watching. We now declare that Mei has been denied. But we are interested in hearing your tactics with dealing with Mei in the comments below. And also let us know which hero you'd like us to deny next. Do like this video if you want this series to continue. And until next time, take care and we'll see you then.